That is where Abraham could have remained in that place and will not succeed. Because he leave that place. This is your father's land, your mother's land. So he has to go somewhere before God could bless him. Maybe there is some of it that is under the sound of my voice. Where you are now is not your location. At the same time, Isaac wanted to run. The Lord says, stay there. The problem we have in the Christendom, and sorry to use this word, in the Pentecostalism, we enter somewhere and we want God to follow us. Instead of God to be the one to enter first and direct us. We want God to follow our agenda. Instead of us to follow God's agenda. Did God tell you to go this way? But when you now get there and get frustrated, get stuck, you say God is wicked. And do you know the funniest thing? You may not believe it. God will never support what he did not start. You are supposed to be going towards this place. And you say, because Abu Dhabi is a big city, and you're supposed to follow Ali. And you now begin to say, Lord, you are in the middle of Ali Road. Lord, follow me. God will just be looking. Did I tell you to follow that place? I don't know the forest. Until you come back to this place and start going that place before God will start following you. It happened to Abraham. He said, do not take anyone with you. He took a lot. Do you know that God kept quiet for 25 years? Now remove 25 years from your age. Where must I be? Where you want to be must be is very important in the school of prosperity. And at the same time, many of our blessings are outside your comfort zone. Then the last one, before we pray, what must I do? You must be a giver. That's why if you see Muslim, Buddhist, anyone that know how to give financially, God will bless you. Now, if you're a Christian, you know how to give, especially for those in the household of faith. You should know the number of blessings that, because give and it shall be given unto you. Let me tell you something, and nothing but the truth. If you want financial prosperity, prayer does not answer it. Hello? I like prayer. Only giving answers to prosperity. And not giving, that everybody will know that give. Giving that you are not expecting anything in return. It is only God that can give. That can give you in return. What must I do? You must be a tithe payer. Listen and listen very well. I know everybody don't like this topic. If you don't pay your tithe, things will be tighter. It's not a curse. It's in the word of God. Your tithe is an insurance for you. For your money. I do know the funniest thing. If you don't pay your tithe, you pay sevenfold to the devil. Now, somebody will say, after all, I use my money to pay my bill, to do this. The time devil is coming to collect that sevenfold, you must have forgotten that you didn't pay your tithe one time. When you don't pay your tithe, let me tell you something. Thank God your pastor here is not collecting any salary from the church. It's even from what is even the one doing many of the jobs financially too. He started to sow to the kingdom of God because he wants to be blessed. When you pay your tithe, it's for your own life, for your own family, for your own blessing. If your office reduces your salary by 20% today, you will still work and you will survive. It's a test. It's a proof it to do. Just do it for me. I learned this tithe pay in a very hard way. My mother taught me how to tithe. Even that's why we were all bad boys. But because our pocket will say, bring your tithe. So we were used to tithe when we were growing up. Now, of course, I've left home for several years. I bought a car. In fact, specifically 2004. A BMW, that I decided to bring money for a car from Cotonou. And because of the money that was involved, I said, this month, I don't think I can pay my tithe. How much was the tithe? 15,000 naira. That night, they've not paid the salary. I just had in my mind that I was not going to pay my tithe that I will postpone it next month, that God will borrow me. You know, we can use any language when we talk, when it talks to God. That night at Oregon Road, that being was a write-off. In fact, God did not just allow me to be dead. Because when people go there, they say, they are not dead. I used over 450,000 naira to repair the BM. Because of, do you know that I still paid that tithe for that month? I still went to pay money for Thanksgiving. That did not, from that moment, if you like carry gun, that tithe must go to God. In fact, there should be a level you get to, you pay your tithe in advance. Hallelujah. There should be a level you get to, 10% should not be your tithe, because that leads to where you become a kingdom promoter. When you become a kingdom promoter, God will never leave you. Amen. You are looking for money. I want to have a good job. I want to have this. If at the back of your mind you say, so that I can be able to do more things for the Lord, the next one will you get a new job. Amen. But if you are looking for a new job because you want to feed your mouth, God will give you a job that will feed your mouth. Because God knows that if I bless this man, no, there are some people here, God knows that I want to take cloud of his glory to the around the world. I need to bless 7 people. It's not just saying we will just choose. He will look at the 7 people that will be ready to release everything. Kingdom promoter. Kingdom promoter. Be an addicted kingdom promoter. They said they want to do a joint service from in this place, Ajma to this place. Say, I want to be part of it. How much is the transportation? 1,000 dirham. Take 100 dirham to be part of it. Do you know what you have done? The person that come from Ajma to this place and got deliverance, you know what you have been? You are part of the blessing. The Lord will help us in the name of Jesus. And somebody will say, what of somebody, whether our salary is very small? I want to ask one question. If I have 2 questions. Since you have not been paying your tithe, have you balanced? That's question number 1. Now, since you have not been paying your tithe, has the church of God stopped? So that means when you pay, it's for your own good. The church of God can never stop because of any man not paying tithe. The Lord will help us in Jesus' name. Today is today. We are going to pray. But before we pray, there was a story I heard. I don't know if I've shared before. Assistant manager and manager in like a KFC. And suddenly, there was a policy that nobody, anything you want to eat about chicken, eat it in the shop. Don't take it home. But there was a day that the manager was taking the KFC, the chicken home, and the assistant manager saw him. Sir, have you forgotten the policy from head office that we should not take chicken to our home? He said, please help me. So the next day, anytime the manager called the assistant manager, please go and do this. He will say, I can't do it, but I'm your manager. I say, remember the chicken. So as soon as I say, remember the chicken, the manager will say, no worry, don't worry, I will go and do it. And it became an everyday thing. Go and sign this thing. I can't sign it, sir. Why? Remember the chicken. Until one day, the manager realize that I'm in bondage. And he went to the owner of the shop and said, sir, I've offended you. There was a time you make a law that nobody should take chicken away. This is me. I've taken chicken away, and assistant manager saw me, and since that time, he has been accusing me. Anytime I want to send in on errand. And the man say, but you could have come to meet me now. So don't worry, just go. You are forgiven. Now, the next day came. The assistant manager came. I was ordering the manager. The manager said, my friend, go and do this thing. He said, remember the chicken. He said, which chicken? I will go and tell the boss. He said, go and tell the boss. Anytime you want to make progress, you want to move forward, the accuser of the brethren, he has some things against you. And he will just flash it in the air and say, this guy is not qualified. But because we're in the house of mercy, the mercy will override it. Yeah. In the name of Jesus, shall we rise on our feet, please?
all lights closed. If you are here, you've not given your life to Jesus Christ. Don't let the devil begin to move around and say, remember the chicken concerning your life. Just raise up around where you are. Because God is about to deliver somebody totally from poverty. But there's no way deliverance can come without holiness. Just raise up around where you are. And let me, if you find out that you need, you want to give your life to Jesus Christ, or you are not living a holy life, you know you are doing mago-mago somewhere, that the devil may want to use it against you, just raise up here where you are. Just raise up here where you are. And because when you openly identify with Jesus Christ, he will openly disgrace the devil. Just from that, just the set of here, just come forward. If you have raised up here, just come forward. Just come forward. Because today is your day of deliverance. It's your day of salvation. It's your day of deliverance. Come. Jesus wants you. Come. 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 Don't negotiate by saying, I don't want people to see me. It is your personal life. When you make it today, people will make friends with you. Come. I want us that are still in congregation to just stay towards them. As this one has registered with Jesus today, the mercy of God will override every of their past mistake. In the name of Jesus, that their name will be written in the book of life. In Jesus' name we pray. Father Lord, we lift up your children unto your holy hand. We know that everyone is rejoicing now, because this is the main purpose of this program, to bring more souls to the kingdom. All these souls, Lord, they have decided to follow you fully, Lord. It is not by any man of God doing or any bad church doing. It's by you, O Lord, that bring people. If you don't bring people to yourself, nobody will be with you. But you have bring these people to yourself. Lord, write their name in the book of life. Sanctify them. Let them grow in the Lord. Everything in their life that the devil may have been using to torment them, accuse them from getting, Lord, let them enter their inheritance in the name of Jesus. I don't take all the glory, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Please, I want you to names, please, because I will even need a copy of the name, because it has become a prayer movement for me. Jeffrey, next time I see you, it's going to be a testimony in the name of Jesus. So please, just one. And the rest of us, I want us to begin to sing this song. There is power, there is power, there is power in the blood. There is power.
There is power in the Lord. There is power, there is power, there is power in the blood. There is power. Let the message of God from
from person to person, from person to person, from person to person. In Jesus' name we pray. Say every trap of poverty,
every trap of poverty,
fashioned against me. Say it
louder.
Scatter. In the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and try to pray for yourself. Please, we are going to use boldness for this next level. Say, use spiritual tips.
Use spiritual tips.
Say it again.
Use spiritual
tips. Say it louder.
Use spiritual
tips. Release my prosperity. In the name of Jesus.